I could fillet you with the scriptures, man, so you better watch out.
I could fillet you, man, so you better watch out.
Yo, what's up, pimp? This threats. That's right, this threats, pimp.
I could fillet you with the scriptures, man, so you better watch out. I'm really trying to hold my tongue here, okay? I'm trying to be nice. And I want to demonstrate the madness that went on in this comment section here, okay? If you aren't aware who IOCK is, he has a channel dedicated to hating on Israelites. His whole channel is dedicated to attacking and tearing down and slandering and lying about Israelites. In response to this video, all I posted was, IOCK, stop fighting us and come into the truth, bro. I said that very nicely and very respectfully. This was his response. When I read the Bible, I see the opposite that One West teaches. Help me see what you claim, please and thank you. Where does it say God is only going to save Israelites and nobody else? Well, I responded to this with about 5 or 6 scriptures, and these are the scriptures that I responded with up here. He deleted my comment.
Your Honor, I object!
And wrote, first, do not write 20 verses, stop. 1 or 2 verses, I'm not writing a novel for you. And we can go through all these. I actually don't think I added any extra commentary or my own breakdown. I just posted the verses because these verses are very clear about who salvation is for. Isaiah 14 and 2. And the people shall take them and bring them to their place, and the house of Israel shall possess them in the land of the Lord for servants and handmaids. And they shall take them captives whose captives they were, and they shall rule over their oppressors. This is end times connotation talking about slavery in the kingdom and the enemies of the Israelites being put into captivity in vengeance and injustice for what they did to us. IOCK's breakdown of this is that it already happened. With no expansion on this at all, I don't know if this Ezra stuff is supposed to be Ezra 2 and 1. Oh my God. This is talking about Israelites going into captivity. I knew that as soon as I looked these verses up, I was going to see craziness. These verses do not prove this happened. These verses are showing the opposite of what happened. Ezra 2 and 1 is discussing Israelites going into captivity. IOCK's doctrine and ideology and Christian beliefs are getting in the way of him properly understanding and reading the Bible. Ezra 2 and 1 is talking about Israelites going into captivity, which already happened. Isaiah 14 is discussing Gentiles going into slavery.
And this is why IOCK started debunking the One West madness, or better said, the blinding of the Most High.
IOCK's breakdown of this is that it already happened.
This man brings up Isaiah 14 and the Israelites leaving Babylon, under Nebuchadnezzar, back to their land with servants and handmaids. I showed him Ezra 2 where this took place. He then Googles Ezra chapter 2, looks at it for 3 seconds and claims.
Ezra 2 and 1. Oh my God. This is talking about Israelites going into captivity.
You can't make this up. He literally read 2 words, and immediately decided that Ezra 2 does not say Israelites left the captivity of Babylon, under Nebuchadnezzar, and returned back into their homeland.
Oh my God. This is talking about Israelites going into captivity.
Let's see what the Bible says. Is Ezra 2, Israelites returning from exile out of Babylon? Or like this man claims, after a 3-second read, it's Israelite going into Babylonian captivity.
Chapter 2. Now these are the children of the province that went up out of the captivity of those which had been carried away, whom Nebuchadnezzar the king of Babylon had carried away unto Babylon, and came again unto Jerusalem and Judah, every one unto his city.
And the people shall take them, and bring them to their place, and the house of Israel shall possess them in the land of the Lord for servants and handmaids.
The whole congregation together was 40,002,303. Beside their servants and their maids of...
For servants and handmaids.
Beside their servants and their maids, of whom there were 7,337. And
I knew that as soon as I looked these verses up, I was going to see craziness.
I could fillet you with the scriptures, man, so you better watch out.
I'll chop you up, put you inside the mattress like drug money.
Yeah, I told you niggas 9-10 times, stop f***ing with me.
I could fillet you with the scriptures, man, so you better watch out.
Put that knife in you, take a little bit of life from you. Am I frightening you? Shall I continue? I put the gun to you. I let it sing you a song. I let it hum to you. The other one sing along.